What's up, guys? This is Fernand here with a little tutorial about how to make a physical sky. That's what it's called inside Cinema 4D. Physical sky. But one minute, I'm just checking actually something. Audio options. Yeah, that's all gets recording. I always set my audio options up for like recording the computer. So whatever sound comes through the speakers, it records it clear as fuck. Usually I don't forget. I forget to change it back to the webcam mic, so it's all good. But yeah, we're gonna run through how to make a physical sky, or in other words, a realistic sky, in Cinema 4D. So what you want to do is you want to go and grab the physical sky. So plonk that in, and what you can see is you can see a nice sunny day, I guess. There's the sun up in the air, and the rest is blue sky, with the horizon obviously. It looks pretty nice, but that's not the end of it. If you click on the physical sky, you've got these little tabs, time and location, sky, sun, details. These are basically the settings. That means you can have light, dusk, dark, and if you render it out, it has stars and shit. I need to really put like a floor down, just so you can see. Obviously this is all the land, I'm not going to go doing major things to it, but yeah, there's some stars in the air, it's night time. So you can really much adjust that to what you would really like. So I'm going to keep it at 12 o'clock, midday. The sky. I wouldn't really change that. I don't really know what to do with that. But obviously the sun, you can change the colour of the light, which I don't know why you'd want to turn it green, but I don't know if that does anything. No. Oh, well. It just stays where it wants to, but the shadow you can change. Now, if you're gonna put a say like a block in Cinema 4D and you're gonna render it, the shadows may be a bit too dark. But if you want to change that, it's not like a normal light shadow. Like it's not like normal one of these where you can just turn the shadow density down. For the physical sky, all you'll have to do is click on the sun, scroll down to the shadow, and then change the colour of the shadow and turn it to more grey. The more towards white it goes, the less the shadow actually is shown, as you can see here. But that's entirely up to you. You do what you would like with the shadow. So what we need to do, we'll just run a few more things now. Click on the basic tab, scroll down. These are all like the sort of settings you have for the sky. So just look up into the air. Maybe you want to add some clouds. So scroll down, check on clouds. And you've got some clouds in here. And then every time you check on one of these, the new tab appears. So as you can see, clouds isn't there. Clouds is here. So if you click on clouds, you can select the layers and you can choose the type of cloud it is, obviously, and you got several layers, so you can have a mix and match with some of them. That looks shite, but what the fuck is that all about? But okay, but yeah, just normal looking clouds like this, and you can have a little play around with that, see what you want to do, and you can turn the layers off. In fact, you don't actually need to have all the layers. So let me just take off ones I don't really want. Yeah, say that. That looks shit, but you know. Let's go to basic. Let's see what other ones. Fog. Now I don't really know how to use the fog, but fog doesn't always work for me. So what I do instead is I use atmosphere. Turn off fog. Turn on atmosphere. Now that is sort of like a fog as well. Intensity, I'm just trying to think how to do this. Yeah, obviously you can see here, if you keep that up to 300 say, oh well, it's not working, but I know it's something to do with the atmosphere, because when you come to that's alright actually, that's like a fade, horizon fade. So it doesn't have to be a sharp line. You can if you want it to, but you can actually fade it a little bit if you would like. That's not really much different, but 60 maybe. Yeah, it sort of fades in. And you can just add the rest of your stuff. So what else have we got? Sunbeams. I've never actually done this before, but let's have a look. God, that's going to be a render killer. Sunbeams. I can't see any sunbeams. Intensity. Distance. I'm going to play around. But yeah, that's all you gotta do. It's just like I said, I'm not an expert at everything. So you have to have a little play around, see what looks best, and you know, you just build yourself a little scene going or something. So hopefully you make this put it to good use. And that, if you have any questions about it, I will try and answer them. Like I said, I don't really know that much about it, but it's all I know is just the basics about adding clouds in the time. There's another thing I'll quickly run through. You can actually run through I'll show you. I don't know how to explain it, but if you want to go from 12 o'clock midday to 12 o'clock midtime really fast, click the auto keyframe button on and just have a little, just move it around just so it changes the value. Just leave that back on 12 though, and it should set keyframe down, but it's not, so maybe if I move it along here, there we go, now it's set the keyframes down. So come back to the start, that's on 12, come to 30, drag this to 30 frames, and we want to go all the way to midnight, like 12 hours ahead, midnight, and check off the auto keyframe button. What I'll do is that will now skip through the time as I come through the keyframes. You can see the time's changing. And if you animate that, it'll be like it's basically like you're taking a video recording of the sky for the whole day, and then you just speed it up to like 2 seconds. You've seen that sort of effect on like films or adverts or something like that. So that's how to do that. And obviously the cloud and that will obviously have to be animated as well, I think, because I doubt they will move, which they're not. But yeah, you can probably animate the clouds or something. Somehow. Change the density, I don't know. But yeah, have a little play around and see what you can do. So I hope you like this tutorial. Like and comment and subscribe, and see you in the next video. Peace.